I worked in the field of architecture for a year, and it wasn't exactly what I was looking for. I enjoyed the job and I got paid well, just wasn't fulfilling what I needed. My journey to finding the Air Force was mainly through my father and my grandfather and my cousin. I followed in their footsteps and said, let's do it. I went to the recruiter, researched some jobs. I found this engineer apprentice job, and I knew that was the only one I was going to take. And I did not sign a contract for over a year until I saw the contract said engineering apprentice. My first duty station was F.E. Warren Air Force Base in Cheyenne, Wyoming. It is the oldest Air Force base in the world, and it is one of the few bases that does not have a runway. I didn't know what to expect. My role as an engineering apprentice is making maps for the base. If anybody calls, say they need floor plans to design the building or they need a bus route, you're constantly getting called about where water lines or utility lines are. I'm on a base that has million-dollar assets. I've had to survey certain things that are directly impacting those assets, so it's a big job. You gotta be focused because it's a lot of little things that you gotta know, whether it's setting up a tripod specifically how it needs to be set up. If you punch in a number wrong, it's gonna throw something off completely. You need to be willing to learn and accept, hey, I need to ask somebody for help. I didn't learn by slow and steady. My supervisor at the time kind of did trial by fire, and he said, here you go, here's a map, make it. He didn't hold my hand. I had to learn the hard way. Now, I was grateful for it because it taught me to be able to figure out things on your own and problem solve. One of the most recent projects I got to work on was a prime beef contingency operations site. I helped design plans, course of actions, helped survey the land and level it out. It was great work on the project because I got to work alongside a lot of other shops and meet a lot of people in the squadron that I didn't get to meet. The culture of the Civil Engineering Squadron is like a big family. If I call and I say, hey, I need help from structures or plumbing, they'll help. They'll do the best they can. They'll do whatever they can. They'll give you anything they can. When I got here, I didn't know how to Air Force per se. And I had spent the holidays here, first time away from my family for the full holidays. But I made some great friends in the shop. And I went to their house for Christmas and New Year's and spend time with them. Master Sergeant Hubley has been like a mother to me here. She has definitely guided me and slapped me in the hands a couple times, but the job has been great and it's been smooth transition. Me and my dad grew up really close. We did everything we could together. We worked on cars together. We went hunting together. We went to concerts together. He put a lot of pressure on me to do better, do the best I can at everything. He told me a saying growing up my whole life, walk around like you're 10 foot tall and bulletproof and you'll get through life. He's not saying be cocky, he's just saying walk around like you know what you're doing, get things done. Be brave, because you have to be brave out here in the middle of Wyoming. I'm 1,500 miles away from my family, so he was a big role in who I am and how I handle things in my life. I don't know if I'm gonna be in 4 years, 10 years, 20 years, but it doesn't matter how long I'm in, I just wanna do the best I can, so when I look back, I'm like, I did what I could. My name is A1C Darian Bogart, and I'm a United States Air Force civil engineer.